Hi, I'm Chloe Beswick, the University's Copyright and Licences Officer based in Library and Learning Services. This short video discusses copyright, audiovisual material, and what you need to consider in university work and assignments. So, to start, what is copyright? Copyright is an intellectual property right that gives the creator of a work exclusive rights to copy, distribute, and make adaptations to a work. For example, if you take a photo, you own the copyright to that photo, so you get to decide who copies, distributes and adapts that photo. In the UK, the current copyright law is the Copyright Designs and Patents Act 1988. We all have a duty to follow the rules as set out in the legislation, whether we are students, teachers or any other professional. Copyright protects literary works, dramatic works, musical works, artistic works, music and sound recordings, films, broadcasts, typography, computer-generated works, databases, crown and parliamentary works. Different types of works have different periods of copyright protection. For literary, dramatic, musical and artistic works, copyright lasts for 70 years from the end of the year in which the author or creator has died. This video is going to focus on audiovisual materials, but it's important to recognise that all works have copyright protection. Copyright is an automatic right that applies to original fixed works. You don't need to apply for copyright, but it only protects original works, works you've contributed your skills or ideas to, and fixed works, not just an idea, but something that has been recorded. Copyright owners may make it clear who owns the copyright to a work using the copyright symbol, the date and their name, but it isn't a requirement. If they don't, copyright still applies. Copyright can be sold, transferred or given away. Usually the creator will own the copyright, but often this isn't the case. For example, I have produced this video using content written by both myself and a couple of my colleagues. However, we don't own the copyright as we produced it as part of our paid work for the university, so the copyright is actually owned by York St John. It's important to look out for copyright symbols and information about who owns the copyright for an image or audiovisual work. Just because an image or video is available online, it doesn't mean it's freely available to use. But I'm a student. As a student, exceptions to copyright mean that you can use audiovisual materials or any works in your university work and assignments so long as you reference them fully and give appropriate credit. However, some university work and assignments may go public, shared outside of the university, such as blog posts, and in this case, you must comply with all copyright rules. This means identifying the copyright status of the audiovisual material and determining whether you can reproduce it publicly. Failure to comply with copyright rules, copyright infringement, can lead to legal action, wider investigations, financial costs, and reputational damages. Copyright can be complicated at times, but there are ways to find and use audiovisual materials that are free to use. Public domain audiovisual materials are works that are in the public domain, meaning that they belong to the public. These are works that have no copyright attached to them, so you can use them without asking for permission. Good sources for public domain works include Wikimedia Commons, Unsplash and Pixabay, but check the materials for any licences and conditions before you use any of them. So as an example of a resource available in the public domain, I found an image that is free to use on Pixabay. Before including this image in the presentation, I checked the license conditions, which state that it is free to download, free to use, even for commercial purposes, and no attribution is necessary. However, in this case, because I've taken a screenshot of the web page for this video, I've referenced Pixabay. A lot of audio and visual materials are now licensed under Creative Commons licenses. Creative Commons is a way of licensing works that allows reuse and sharing, whilst also allowing creators to retain some of their rights. Creative Commons offers 6 licenses using 4 different license elements, and how people can use different works depends on which license has been applied. The license elements include attribution, BY. You can use the resource, but you must give credit to the original creator. Share alike, SA. You can use and modify the resource, but you must retain the same license terms of the original version of the resource. Non-commercial, NC. You can use a resource for any purpose, so long as it's non-commercial. No derivatives, ND. You can use the resource in its original form, but cannot modify it without obtaining additional permission from the creator. So long as you comply with the Creative Commons license applied to a work, you can use that work in your own assignments. When looking for resources licensed under a Creative Commons license, you might want to consider OpenVerse, a search engine for resources with Creative Commons licenses. It also has links to help pages which explain how to correctly attribute works. An example of an image licensed under a Creative Commons license is on this slide. I've included a diagram showing the different Creative Commons licenses. This image is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license, so I'm free to use it so long as I acknowledge the creator, which I have done so by referencing the image. If appropriate, you may be able to use a copyright protected work by relying on a copyright exception. In UK copyright law, there are various exceptions to copyright that allow for the reuse of copyright protected works, but these mainly apply within education and research settings. Many of these are fair dealing exceptions and are based on the idea that reuse should be limited and fair. It is copyright exception research and private study that permits students to use copyright protected works in their university work and assignments. Outside of education, in a professional capacity, you may be able to rely on copyright exception quotation to use a protected work. For example, you may need to use an image to critique, review, or quote something. However, relying on copyright exceptions in a professional capacity can be somewhat risky, especially if the copyright owner disagrees with your use of their work or thinks what you're doing isn't fair. To avoid potential copyright infringement cases, businesses and employers usually prefer to ask permission from the copyright owner or pay license fees. There may come a time when you are doing a piece of work, for example, writing a blog post, and you come across an audiovisual work that is perfect for what you require, but it isn't in the public domain or licensed under a Creative Commons license. You could consider relying on a copyright exception, but this could be somewhat risky, particularly in a professional or commercial capacity. If this is the case, you will need to ask permission from the copyright owner to use that work. Asking for copyright permission can involve a lot of work and isn't always straightforward. You would need to identify who owns the copyright to that work and find a way to contact them, ideally in writing. You would need to provide them with a full description of what you want to use and how you will be using that work. I recommend that you give the copyright owner as much information as possible and ask for their response and permission in writing. If you don't know the copyright owner, or the owner has said no, you must not use that work. If the copyright owner has said yes, but have given you guidelines, you must follow them. When asking for permission, there can also be costs involved, such as license fees. When seeking permission direct from copyright owners, the costs involved can be expensive, particularly for audiovisual materials such as images. Many businesses purchase licenses for image and media libraries. While single user and personal licenses are available, these aren't always suitable for businesses who need to purchase business or commercial licenses. Access can be expensive but necessary when using images for commercial purposes. Purchasing a license can cost less than the legal costs should they potentially infringe copyright. Prices will vary depending on what image businesses use, what they use the image for, and the size of the business. For example, this image on the slide would cost £375 to use, and there are conditions included as to how and where the image can be used. Importantly, whether you are using a resource that is in the public domain, licensed under a Creative Commons license, or something that you have sought permission to use, you must recognise the creator and acknowledge them in your references. A lack of reference could be considered copyright infringement. For reference and support and guidance, please contact your academic liaison librarian. So, to summarise, think, check, submit. When you find an audiovisual resource, think about whether you can use it. Who owns the copyright, whether it's in the public domain, licensed under a Creative Commons license, or whether you need permission. Check whether you have referenced the resource correctly, whether your use complies with the Creative Commons license, or check if you have permission from the copyright owner. Once you have thought and checked, you should be ready to submit and know that you have considered copyright, taken all of the required steps, and provided reference and credit to others where necessary. So, for further information and help about copyright, please see our copyright web pages. For referencing support, you can contact your academic liaison librarian, and for digital skills support, you can contact Digital Training.